today what I have is, first we will look into a filter tip. In order to appreciate that filter tip, first we will do our conventional way or traditional way, how we put filters in a dashboard. Then next we will see the our new tip, like how to drop. So let me make a visualization consisting of the year, order date, and sales. And also let me drop the category in colors, so we'll be able to view category sales. So this is the simple visualization. If you would like to filter it based on category and subcategory, what we'll do, we'll drop the category in filters. For the time being, let's select all apply, and also subcategory also we'll just drop and select all and apply. So if you would like to view some particular category or subcategory, so filter. And you will be unchecking and checking. Once it comes to dashboard, we won't feel like having this full list. You will just use a single value drop down when it comes to dashboard to save space and all. So this is the traditional way of doing, making the visualization and dropping the fields which has to be put in filter. But let's quickly see a new way where you should have multiple options and so on. So let me get back the visualization by removing the filters in the pane. So this is the sheet in which filter has to happen, and we will create a separate sheet for filtering. So let me drop the category and subcategory. Text. Okay. Let me expand. Okay, so now we have two sheets. We will try to put both of them in dashboard, but before dropping them into dashboard, we will just try to add one more feature into the sheet. This sheet we will ensure once the client wants, only in that case it will be visible. So to show our hide sheet, we will create a parameter. So create parameter, let's name this as filter sheet. List. Show. Hide. Show parameter. I will write a calculator field considering the parameter. Then two. So if I give an option as to show in filter sheet parameter, then I want this sheet to be displayed in dashboard, or else I don't want. So that's why I'm writing this field. Show ride, apply. Let me drop this into filter. True. I'll select apply. Okay. So when I hide, the entire sheet goes off. Also, we know it tied together. Once I give show, this sheet comes up. Let's do a little bit of formatting as well. Okay, so now we got a filter sheet and the sheet one consisting of visualization. So let's drop this in a dashboard and see how to connect these sheets. So sheet, first let me drop a vertical. Sheet 1 is the one consisting of the visualization, and sheet 2 is the one with the filter values. So we got this. Now we will create, we will try to show the parameter with our. Sorry. So So now if you want to hide the sheet, if you click hide, it will hide off. Else if you would like to show, it will show. You got that. Now how to connect these both sheets for filter action. So here, once you select the sheet, we'll have an option. Generally what people suggest is like to go dashboard, and there will be option for dashboard actions. There you have to add action, filter, then select sheet 1, sheet 2, and give selected fields. All these, it's a kind of bit time taking. What you can do is just you can select the filter which is used as filter. Once you select, by automatically now this both, since we have here, we will have only two sheets, so it doesn't matter. In some cases, when you have specifically one filter action to take place on particular sheet, then you can go for the dashboard again and select so and so. So now we selected. So if you select these bookcases, you'll be able to view only bookcases. Along with bookcases, if you'd like to view office supplies, then you can click here as well. If you would like to take up something from technology, you can click here. So here, all filter action is done in one single go. If at all you look the other one, you have to go for category, then change, then subcategory change. And also, if you would like to hide this also, you can hide. But once you hide, the filter actions will go off. And also, apart from this, if you would like to have this as float, then it's also a good idea to have it as, instead of fixed, you can have it as float. But currently, if you see, you can see there is a white background, and it's like kind of not satisfactory. So if, in order to remove the white background, what you can do is, and this is actually a very useful tip. If you go inside that particular sheet, right click, format, and when you go shading, currently it's selected white one. If you change it to none, it will be like no background at all. So now you'll be able to visualize the grid lines whichever comes into the visualization. And the inspiration is of this idea came from yesterday's session, after like Swab has taken the Power BI showing a separate sheet for filtering action and so I thought like in Tableau how we can make, and I thought of this way. So this is the first tip I had for today. Any doubts? Okay, we'll move on to the second one. So the next one is more focused on like how to play with icons in Tableau visualization. The recent project in which I worked, I came around like many situations where you have to work a lot on icons to get more customized one. So just let me create a visualization for them. Though here the icon and data are not relevant, we will try to take the features like how to implement in Tableau, and those takeaways we will take, leaving the data and the icons which we are trying to present here. So let me make it. So for the time being, I have filtered only furniture. Sales is in bars and profit, let me drop it. Let me do it way like this as well. Way like this. Synchronize axis. So now we have two way axis out for sales and profit. Let me hide the header and convert sales to bar and profit to some shape. Okay, so here we all know, but just for a quick recap, if you would like to add any template or any icon into Tableau, what we are supposed to do is, we have a, in my documents we do have a folder saying my Tableau repository. So once if you go to documents, there will be my Tableau repository, and here we will have a separate dedicated folder for shapes. There you can create new folder and add the icons whichever you would like to. So here I have added a K cases on separate folder. So, and I have added two icons. So we will just try, and this is the way we will try to add customized icons into Tableau. So first you have to go to my documents, then my Tableau repository and shapes, and if you create folder and you can add, you'll be able to see here. So for profit, let me go for cases, and let me select this globe icon for this. Currently you are not able to see icon because the message names is dropped into color. Let me remove it. So now we are able to see. And in this case, we don't have much issue because the icon is opaque and anyway, the background won't be shown at any point and it's okay to have this icon. But assume a case where we have one more icon, something like this one. If you apply, you can see this is circular and there is a square kind of white background which doesn't sync or which doesn't look good with the visualization. To get rid of this, what we can do is we will just try to remove this white background. So it will have only this globe. So to do that, what you have to do is, when I did some research, I found a site which directly removes off the background. So this is a site remove.bg. Once you upload image directly, so I am uploading this image. Try to upload the image gets uploaded, and by default this site removes the background, and at the end we will get the one without the background. Let's see what's the difference. I'm just copying it and pasting the MyTabby repository. So just KKSS EA represent KKSS deleted icons, and I have dropped this icon here. Let's go there and check more shades. Let me click more. Oh, currently it's not there. Let's reload the shape. And now we are able to see it apply. Okay. So now you can see all those, the white background went off, and now we have only the icon, and now it's like the look and feel. If you compare the earlier one and this one, like this is much better, I would say. And if you want to drop the values and show, then you can just drop it in text, and you can do some formatting where you like to have it on top. And also in this case, you have to change the size of bars accordingly. So we will get the text on the top. We'll try to reduce the size of the text. Yeah. This is a one tip on icon. Like when it comes to translucent or transparent icon, what we are, if you remove the background, the look and feel will be better. And we saw how to remove the background as well. And one more feature icon I would like to add here. Currently the sales and profit, those are in large value and volume. The user is not so much precise about the values, but assume a case like where you have reviews like out of 5, 4.3 or 4.4, the user will be more interested or more precise on where the value lies. In that case, instead of showing this like a circle and here, the user would like to pinpoint or point a value on a particular where it lies in the bar. You can just go forward and add a line on top of this icon. So the user will be knowing exactly like where this icon or where this value lies. So in order to do that, what I thought of is first I add this icon. Then along with the icon, just what I will do is I will go just insert a line on top of this like this. Then I will just format it to like increase the thickness or and change the color and everything. And I will save this icon, save as picture. So I saved this icon over there. Now we will see how to input that, and we have to do slight some modifications, the size and font, all this. So let me input the icon. So now the user will be able to exactly see like where the values exactly lie. Here in this case it doesn't matter, but when it comes to review and all ratings, those are the users are even so much concerned about the decimal values. So in that case, this kind of pointing helps a lot. So user will be able to see exactly where my value lies or where my benchmark of a company lies. You can accordingly adjust the size of bar so it looks better. And so these all are the features or tips and tricks I had for today. And if you guys have any doubt, I answer them, or else we'll close with this.
Just to add to what Jairam was saying, right? This kind of a visualization, it's like a speedometer. It's analogous to a speedometer, I would say, albeit it's on a linear scale rather than on a circular scale. So that mark with that line shows you, how much they have covered. In that way, it helps them get a relative view of the current position. It's very good way of visualizing the thing. Thanks, Jairam, also for that tip on removing the background. Because most of the time, I think we work with the default options in Tableau, but certain advanced visualizations require us to use images. And so far, what I was doing was I would normally use Photoshop to remove that background and then put it where we need, put the transparent image. But if there is a website that does this by default, it saves a lot of time.
Thanks, sir.